why is cheating so common in Black culture?
Ooh, why is cheating so common in Black culture? Mm-hmm. Victoria? Why is cheating so common in Black culture?
I want to start off with the whole like music, like influence of the music industry, music videos, TV, reality TV, all that stuff. We are just consuming it all the time, and all it is portraying is threesomes and polygamous relationships and whatnot. So you always, the Black community is always feeling like what they have is not enough.
Yes,
it's
ma'am.
Not enough for one. So you got to keep going for more. And even even if you grew up on your uncle's porn collection, you're still like, that's ingrained. You have those expectations. Oh, I need this in a wife. I need this in a woman.
Right.
You're not getting that because those are actors. That's not reality. And now you're married. You don't feel like you have enough sexually. So you continue to go out and find some more.
Okay, you gonna start a fire like that?
Yeah, go ahead. What you gonna follow up with, huh?
Oh, okay. listen. Hey, this is the language of kings. I'm giving you tools right now. Listen, the cheating that we hate in our society can't be the cheating that we embrace in our music.
Exactly.
Can't be the cheating that we embrace on our television screen.
Mm-hmm.
So what I mean by that is Black image, right? Because the image right now is that Black, it's cool to cheat.
Mm-hmm.
It's cool to just, you know, have our women out there doing the WAP and bouncing and shaking and gyrating. It's cool to be ignorant on television. This whole Tubi movement. So they got the Tubi TV. I don't know if you saw. They got the Tubi TV stuff, man, where they have all these little Black movies on there. They're like low budget for sure. And stuff like that. People be dying all weird and stuff like that. And whatnot. But the images and stuff that we have as far as Black can't be the continued thing. I'll give an example of that. Okay. Like, it's 2023, right?
Mm-hmm.
Imagine trying to put The Cosby Show on television in 2023.
I already know what kind of character's going to be in there.
You already know, right? And they won't even let it on the television.
If it's not, right.
They're right. They won't let you on television. Imagine if you had like a Family Matters show trying to be on television now, you know, a Black mother, Black father together. Oh, my goodness, they're together, you know, type thing with kids and showing
respect
and love and having a meaning behind the shows and all this type of stuff.
Mm-hmm.
You can't have that as far as Black in 2023. What you get is Real Housewives Atlanta, you know, fighting, we throwing wine on each other, we going crazy, we accusing each other of rape, we're doing all of this type of stuff. You get The View, you get, I was listening to, the other day I was listening to, what's the chick that married Carmella Anthony for a bit? Lala Anthony, right?
Yeah.
And she's on there and she's like, well, you know, I can't get a date now, you know, and she's, you know, you spent all that time in your youth, you know, showing it off, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
You know, doing your thing or whatnot. And now you're at this particular point. And nobody wants that, to commit to that.
Right.
Right? That image is there.
Exclusivity.
I saw, I don't think she's even Black. I think she's mixed. The little bald chick. She got a tattoo on her forehead now. Amber Rose.
Mm-hmm.
It's like, you know, men are gross. I think she's like 40 now. She's like, men are gross after you've been ran through all these men for all these years. And that's the image that's portrayed of you. Now you want to get to the point where you want to be seen as pure. And men are like, nah, we're not buying that.
Right. What happened? You were just marching in the street doing a slut walk saying.
You were just doing that.
And everybody was following you. And now you changed your mind.
Right. Right. It doesn't work that way. And the same thing for men, too. We can't be these gangsters and thugs and living that life. And, you know, now the Black image has been emasculated. Now it's you in a dress
Black
and you being
soft.
Black men
have been emasculated and the Black women have been masculinized or whatever word you want to say.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. And that's something that we can't allow to be a continued thing in our particular culture. But that is what's leading to like cheating. You can't, a man will never fully commit to anything he doesn't fully respect. Facts.
Mm.
That's the language of kings. I'm telling you, listen. But we have to change the image of that stuff if we want to change the results of it.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
You can't be entertained by it. And then also, like, if that's your form of entertainment, that's who you are.
Mm-hmm. And other races have a balance, right? So other races, they get a balance, right? You can get your housewife shows for whatever Asian folks or white folks. You can get those few and far between, but when you see them, you see a balance of it. You see them also as presidents on shows. Mm. You get them mm. in these high arced roles and stuff yeah. like that with drama and all that type of stuff. You get a balance there, but when it comes to black,
it's always the same thing.
Man, listen. We can't continue to live in that particular space by that particular image. And then we're so divided too at the same time. You know what I'm saying? Like the first question, like we were talking about, you like, mm-hmm. like, I don't need you, black man. I don't need you, black woman. And this is the image of us at the same time. That's a, right. that's an ugly concept, right? How do you raise your children in that particular space? All right. So, mm-hmm. so that is what I would say if you're talking about why cheating is such a prominent thing. And we love to see other people get cheated on. Oh, and then yeah. at the same time, hate to be cheated on.
Yeah.
That's a problem for me. Yeah. That's a problem for me.
I got one more to add to that.
Okay, go ahead.
So I also feel like, you know, we were just talking about single parent homes.
Mm-hmm.
What is it, like 60 or 70% of black families grew up in a single parent home. So they aren't witnessing commitment growing up.
Mm-hmm.
So, like 60 to 70% of black people are not witnessing commitment growing up.
Right. Right. That's a high percentage.
Yeah.
That's a super high percentage. And that's why it's so key to have a two parent strong home. Mm-hmm. And when I say two parent, let me make sure I'm clear.
Very. Thank you.
A man and a woman yeah. two parent home. And the data, whether you're looking at a secular data or whatever, the data is very clear that that is the best possible chance for a child to have a strong and healthy grow up, and that's better for the people
their
who are together.
Marriage.
Yeah. So
yeah.
And the enemy knows that too. So the enemy knows that if you got a strong home, right, then you're building mm-hmm. strong neighborhoods, strong society, strong city, strong state, strong country, strong world.
Yeah.
That's the way, that's why marriage is so important
yeah.
because everything is tied to it. You know what I'm saying? Even black. Good stuff.